Alrighty. Hello everyone, I'm Type 1 Dragon, and welcome back to Crusader Kings 3 Tours and Tournaments, the Swedish Crown, and the last installment of our little Crusader Kings 3 series. Just to begin, we have been going on with this game for about 100 years. And while Stakkad the Handsome is only 34 and still has a long life ahead of him, I feel like now is the right time to end this series. As I mentioned from the very start, I'll play through 3 lifetimes of a character, then end the series because I do not want it to go on for a very long time. And while I do still believe in that mindset, and I will be carrying it forward with the next Crusader Kings 3 series that I make, this series has overstayed its welcome for a good while now. I hadn't intended to last as long as it did, and between the start of the series to this point here, 2 new DLCs, I think 3 actually, has come and gone. So I feel that it is time to end this series, but I'm going to end it in a bang. I got a lot of wars planned and a lot of stories to tell. A recap of all that has happened and a look at how Sweden is doing in the modern day. So to begin, it's time to unify the last holdouts of Sampi. This is something that's been in the making for a very, very long time. So, all I'm going to do is just raise my men at arms here. No need to get the full force. Oh. I don't know how I got to the council, but since I'm here, my steward Dubrog has excelled during our recent battles, and my court is buzzing with excitement. What an accomplished knight, what a role model, what a man. With all the praise raining down on him, it's made clear that I'm expected to officially reward him in some manner. He will be gifted gold for his achievements. He is my steward after all. Might as well give him a little bit something. There we go. So we got an independence faction from the Duke of Finland and the Duke of Pohjanmaa. That this war should be over rather quickly. Because you aren't that strong and they're not that strong. Otherwise, I'm going to ask the Pope for some money. Thank you, thank you. And I got something planned with that money here in seconds. But yeah, if things sound a little bit different, no, it's not the mic. I've actually moved rooms from my upstairs bedroom to the downstairs bedroom, because I am downsizing everything to get ready to move. So if things do sound just a little bit different, or if I'm talking much more quieter, or if I take long pauses in between, those are my parents. And I'm being respectful to them as I'm still under their roof by not getting their voices in the recording. So if you see an odd jump, that's most likely me talking to them. But greetings, my beloved, my benevolent liege. I've arrived in Sigtuna to pay homage to you, glorious king, as show of loyalty. I bring you rich gifts worthy of your majesty as a token of my good and well servitude. Show Count Lohaus, who is Sammy, in at once. I wait patiently on my throne for the arrival of Count of Harris, who soon announced and ushered before me. He kneels in deference, as attendants bring forth his gifts of coin and precious objects. The oath is taken, and scribes record his pledges to serve the kingdom of Sweden. At last, I bid the count arise, confirming my satisfaction and Lothar's rights to the lands he rules in my stead. I accept your generous gifts, count. A strange noise. I arrived back at my castle after a long, lonely walk. Another year passed, another year older. I was born this day 35 years ago. The older I get, the more I cherish the relationships I have cultivated over the years. Someone tells me that I have not heard from my wife, Komofjod, or any of my friends today. I trudge along to my chambers, loneliness impeding my lazy feet. I hear a clang and hushed whispers from down the hallway. What could that be at this hour?
Oh! That's neat. It shows you where the event comes from. That's interesting.
Happy birthday. What a surprise. All my nearest and dearest friends have come together to wish me well as I begin this next year of life. There's even an entire table laden with seven cakes and my favorite. Here, I was thinking that everyone had forgotten about me. I could not believe that Homofjota went to all the troubles of arranging this in secret. I had not a clue such a thoughtful surprise was being planned at all. My friend Girle approaches me, struggling to carry three beautiful wrapped packages. Ever the trickster, she says, I have three gifts here for the choosing. One shall be yours, but which should it be? We'll go with the biggest one. Oh, we get a mace. Skogan mace. Prowess plus 5 and 9 effectiveness plus 6. That's actually really, really good. That's better than our Swedish class, so thank you very much. And a commander has been promoted. My Marshal Duke George very hesitantly brings my guest Tillahop, a Karelian, to my door. Duke Gisela has asked me to promote Tillahop to the honor of commandership, but I believe that you might wish to have say in this matter beforehand. Tillahop frowns his brows. He's not that good of commander. Yeah. My armory's not a nursery. Sorry. You're also Orthodox. How? When did you become Orthodox? That might be a problem. Not like I already have a bunch of problems anyway, but let's get some gold here. So, you might be wondering what I was planning on doing with that gold from the Pope. And this whole series has been about the tours and tournaments, DLC, and all the stuff that you can do. We've been to a grand tournament held by the King of Norway long ago. We've held a luxurious feast and we have gone on several hunts. So we have done a tournament, but we really haven't done a tour. It was a magnificent tour and pay a visit to your vassals and their lands. Each stop will have a 2-month duration. Anticipated rewards from hosting a grand tour are kind control, popular opinion, and stress loss. Tour success rewards, level 1, prestige, level 2, opinion, level 3, visit vassal opinion, level 4, ill-turned liege, which gives plus 15 vassal contribution, and development in the capital. And magnificent liege gives plus 5 vassal limit, which is honestly pretty good for 10 years, and 20% contribution and 0.3 growth a month. Of course, I'm going to hold a grand tour. But what kind of tour? A majesty's tour? A majesty's tour. Some events will allow especially majestic actions. Taking these earns prestige and vassal opinion, which is always good. Both when departing from a stop and at the end of your grand tour. This grand tour is the opportunity to show my subjects that I am a just, benevolent, and majestic liege. Intimidation tour. Some events will allow especially dreadful actions. Taking these earns dread. When you part from a stop, you may attempt to force vassals out of hostile factions. This grand tour is an opportunity to put my subjects in their place and show how truly terrifying I can be. Or a taxation tour. Some events will allow adversus actions. Taking these earns gold both when departing from a stop and at the end of your grand tour. This grand tour is an opportunity to remind my vassals that I am owed tax and obligation and to rule out any and all tax avoidance within my realm. Well, for that, let's look at Grimm's personality. Yes, he is a little bit dreadful, but that mainly comes from him being albino. He's very strange and he's very intimidating, especially with him being a calculating genius. And as well, pretty strong as well. But at the end of the day, he's a humble, gregarious, albeit a brave man. He does show humility, and he will give respect when respect is due. And so, as the King of Sweden, let me just give this to someone of Swedish culture. He feels that the best way to show his vassals, show his realm that he is a benevolent, just king, because right now his vassals kind of don't see him that way, despite me trying my best to sway them to see me that way, is to go around and do a grand, majestic tour. Show them that he is a just, benevolent, and majestic liege. And so, the best way to plan that is to go literally everywhere. This is going to be a very, well, oh boy, I can't even go to most of the places. So, yeah, I can only select 10 stops. So think of it like that. I definitely need to go to places that have low opinion on me. Which would be best to start over here in Finland. Probably best to start down here, move up into Finland from Estonia, go into Karelia, go there, see one of my more influential vassals. And then end the tour at home. So I will need 1,300 gold for this. Culture Fest, host of dinner. Let's see. I kind of just want to increase everyone's opinion of me during this tour. So I will need 1,356 gold. That shouldn't take too long, especially if I don't do many events that expand goes. So in the meantime, let's hold course. And if you've been watching the series from the very beginning, you know what this event is all about. Jester for the first in line to approach. A hero of the frontier. Over the last few days, I've heard tell of a mighty hero of the peasantry, who has won the hearts and minds of the common people through incredible deeds and matchless bravery. This hero, who goes by the name Azur, has been defending the small folk from the Estonian raiders and has now traveled the way to Stagad to seek an audience with me, Sigtuna. There's no doubt that Azur is a great hero. However, my courts are amended that I do not elevate a commoner beyond their station. Adamant. Well, let's look at Azur. He is brave, he is humble, and he is zealous. He is a brilliant strategist, reckless, but a folder with 25 prowess and 25 martial. I kind of want to make this dude a knight. Yeah, you shall be rewarded with a place in my household. I'm making this dude a knight. And I'm going to get him a good wife. Here we go. Now, open carry. Ooh, I love this event. Two of my vassals are pushing one another and jostling to reach my throne first. Duke George bows before me. My lord, murder is wanton in the city streets throughout the Kingdom of Sweden. It would be civilizing if we institute a ban on townspeople bearing arms, at least within city limits. Count Fisk kicks him out of the way. Safety is each man learning to protect himself. Banning carry of weapons will castrate the townspeople. Let's see. We shall ban weapons within settlement walls. Keep our swords, lest our realm weaken. We shall solve this safety debate with violence. So we will gain open carry permits for 50 years. Ooh. They become rivals. One is my marshal, Duke George, the timid. I feel like I should trust his opinion. Sure, he's calm, he's fickle, and he's chase, but he is a skilled tactician, a strategist, a logician, and a folder with 23 martial and 12 prowess. I should most likely listen to him. If anyone would know better, it would be my marshal. My lord, this is outrageous. Agitated, Duchess Asta stands before my throne. The body of my poor cousin, the recently deceased Captain Beau.
Oh, well said.
It's been violated by the fiend you keep at your court physician, Edla.
My aunt?
That vile monster has tempered with the corpse, using it to practice her obscure knowledge and leaving it disfigured in the face. Please, she cannot go unpunished. Of course, Edla looks appropriately offended by the accusation. I have no idea what that woman's talking about, my lord. Let's see. Flagellated himself to death August 14th, 1146. Flagellated himself to death. They would both. Oh boy. You're also sadistic.
probably go regret this, but I trust Edla. As the last partition departs, various courtiers follow them out of the room, having business to attend elsewhere. Others remain, talking amongst themselves about the recent proceedings. Soon, the ceremony formality of the proceedings has dropped away entirely, with the hum and bustle of normal courtly life taking its place. My business is done. Sorry, accepted a marriage proposal. Let's see. Ransom? Thank you. That's some more money. How did I lose some money? Must have accidentally put in the wrong coin. But let's see. You could be transferred to him, which I will accept, because I want to try and keep my vassals happy. I can negotiate alliance with you, which if I want to take out the King of Norway, so my brother-in-law, and that's my nephew, Helgi. Yeah, I think I'll accept. And let's see, what was your crime? Oh, fornicator. You're also a lunatic. You know what? I'll grant a pardon. And you're also a fornicator. I might as well pardon you. I'm feeling in a good mood. My sister Brigitte is good to be married, and I should definitely get her married to the King of Hungary. You're 36, so the chance of you having kids is very low. There's also my cousin in Denmark. Oh boy. You're allied to the King of Poland. Why is it always the Polish? Although, I think starting to make my way a little bit into Hungary might be better. Well, not Hungary, Byzantium. Sure, vastly inferior, but I can pull an old trick from the family playbook. And I think I will attempt that. While time does tick along, let's take a quick look at how the world has developed. France is in a terrible civil war right now. England has claimed both still holds Normandy, a little bit of, well, they do own Maine, so that is historically accurate to what will eventually happen, but they have Brittany. That is interesting. They own Brittany. Up to the task. Some of my counselors believe the job is theirs by right of blood or influence alone. How wrong they are. I expect results, yet I'm often disappointed. After a long day, I'm complaining to Ormifjorda. When she interrupts me, let me do something about it, husband. A few lessons might sharpen their wits. Let's see. Counselor Hjopjof could use a tutor. You are my counselor. You're already excellent with diplomacy. So 15 years you would gain +2 to diplomacy and +1 to learning and opinion on me, which is always good.
My marshal, likewise, you're already pretty good, and while you do have a slight negative opinion of me, you were doing well. Or there is Duke Brock, my steward, who has 14 stewardship, which is good, but you are ailing. Or I could lay with my wife and have a night with her. But I would be remiss not to take this opportunity to gain some free opinion. I'm sorry. What just happened? What just happened to my... Anyway, I'm going to assign you. Trying to sway you. There's also you. I may not have... If only I didn't have so many powerful vassals, things could probably be a lot easier. But you do have two sons, so the moment you die, your land is getting split into two, which is... a good thing for me, your ally to my cousin. Who's doing surprisingly well. They own a good chunk of Aragon. Well, what should be Aragon. And you're doing surprisingly great. Jeez. You almost sold all of the modern-day borders of Portugal. Mixers, I do. I'm not saying it would be on the struggle in Iberia, but yeah, that is very interesting how it turned out. Even the Pope gained a province, but a province. And the Emperor of the HRE, his crown lands is in Italy, which is interesting. They even share, I guess, a little bit of a... what would you call this situation? A dual monarchy of Corsica? But yeah, the Holy Roman Empire has had an amazing game. They got pretty much all of Burgundy and almost all of Italy, save... You're telling me the seat of French nobility is in Genoa and they're led by an Italian? No wonder you are rebelling. Jeez. And Ruthenia is having a great game as well. Novgorod, not so much. Let's see, 4 more years until that province is converted. It may happen over time as well. But you'll just convert it back as soon as it's converted, so that is a waste. Instead, I know I'm trying to save up for a grand tour. But when I see an opportunity like this to fight Novgorod, I should take it. And how are we look? They even changed this up a little bit, which I kind of like. Legacy-wise, I probably should have filled out this whole tree, but we're doing pretty good. I'm about to get a new perk anyway. The Baltic is a complete and utter mess, so it'll be interesting to see how things go. In the Far East, while the Seljuks are, they've seen better days. The Eastern Romans are doing amazing, though. And getting personal. In our recent communication, my vassal, Duchess Asha, expressed a want to focus on her ambition and interests more. I can make sure that our coming letters contain more on a topic close to her heart. a topic close to her heart. Well, she is a diplomat, but she is sadistic, wrathful, and zealous. I guess I'll try the diplomatic route, see how that goes. It was definitely worth a try. With the Kingdom of Sapni, I can form now, same with the Kingdom of Finland. But, oh. The heir that they were voting for, tragically passed away. But now they're voting for my daughter, who is the oldest of my kids. Let's see. I'm teaching you. I would prefer that you would eventually become the heir, but that's alright. Well, let's actually look at the election. I'm also voting. Why am I voting for her? Want to be Gustavus. And I'm stressed. You know what? I'm just as good as the rest. Recently, I feel like I'm not worthy of the King of Sweden. Kingdom of Sweden. Do other rulers doubt themselves as I doubt myself? And my sister, as my aunt, has died of old age. I tried to be a good, humble king, but it feels like my every action reeks of pride. Others in my situation live so modestly. I seem to flaunt my magnificence at each opportunity, and I cannot stand it. Damn this universe for raising one so poor as me to such heights. But no, I am just as good as the rest. And yeah, I guess you do know best. So again, we're making good money, but not a whole. For Scar's claim on the county of Zephyr. Oh. Wow. Breakfast with a friend. I'm on my way to church one morning when I run into Queen Cormifioda. I'm probably saying that wrong, I do apologize. He's carrying a small bag. Glancing around, she conspicuously opens it, revealing all sorts of food and drinks. It's such a beautiful day. Come join me outside for a morning picnic, she says. So I start to protesting that I'm on my way to the church. Cormifioda interrupts me. God will still be there later. But these candid figs won't. The true sin would be letting this opportunity pass. I think my wife is trying to seduce me. I'm fine with that. Let's see. I'll be back when I potentially get this claim on the County of Vjord. Probably be good to unpause. Or when I'm ready for the grand tour. Actually, an opportunity might have just presented itself. I do want to clean up the borders. You know what? Let's scratch this. No, not that. You, fabricate claim there. I want to clean up some of these borders.
Oh. Okay, looks like war is coming to us instead. Greetings, King Stockard of Sweden. May you live in harmony and contentment. Your occupation of lands which rightfully belong to me can no longer be tolerated. It is time that I see them return to my possessions. Livonian claim on the county of Revel. You're allied to the King of Hungary, which is why you feel like that you can beat me. You're also allied to the Duchess of Cornwall. But you chose a target that I could easily defend. And Hungary will take a while for you to get here. And I could call in the tyrant to help. And the prince to help. But I can also call in King Nicholas Bjornsson to help. And Duke Bjorn the Dry to help. Dry. It's considered impossible to tell if he is constantly laughing eternally without no outward sign, or just don't understand the concept of fun to begin with. Don't understand the concept of fun to begin with. Whatever you want to tell yourself, game. But I will definitely be calling you into this war as well. And I'll be raising my army in full. Starting with the men at arms. Granary infestation. Vermin have infested several granaries in the county of Vermunland, destroying the seed grain stored in them. With nothing to plant for next year's crop, the free tenants living there have come to me asking for aid. Given their dire situations, these farmers will ultimately be forced to accept whatever terms I offer them. I have plenty of grain should they become my serfs. My brother will distribute grain to them. I would lose some money, but I would gain piety and grateful for you folk. Yeah, that's the best option. So let's look at this war. Avoiding a claim on the county of Revel. 11,000 troops to almost 20,000. Yeah, I'll be raising everyone. I really do want to try and go on Grand Tour, but I do need to try and keep within our restraint. I shouldn't need all of them. So, you all are going to start sieging there. You start sieging there, and you start sieging there. Well, that is me. I'm not going to lead the siege yet. As long as I can hold Revel and keep them from trying to siege down my own territory, this war should be over rather quickly. And Gustavus is the new player heir of Sweden. Sweet. But you're not getting the main title. That's a bad thing. So, how do we gain ticking war score? I guess just deny them the county? Well, there's Hungary now. They'll probably start sieging down those lands.
Sega Court. Someone's trying to kill someone. Arnold von Akil is no longer my personal champion. He was so good. It's been clear that your archbishop is working to establish a false and superior claim on the county of Amundsen. Do not think that this kind of dishonorable action will go without response.
Well, I guess there is more than one way to try and get a claim.
And that involves giving money to the Pope. Okay, saying that we should win because army supply is running low for them. We have a better army commander and of higher quality. Let's see how this goes. Station procedures, no. Oh, and we're turning the tide. So from that one battle alone, 8,000 to 14,000. We lost 3,000 soldiers. And we had 11,000 survivors. They lost. I lost a good chunk of men. But that wasn't their full force. That's the main thing. I don't know where their full force could be. I'm gonna send you all back to the mainland to go and recover. You go and recover as well. Alright, now I'm going to try and sway you. I do believe that one battle is enough. Hey, a war and language journal. Do I already have one? I do. Let's see. Plus four. You know what? I'm going to reforge it. Yep. And I will go ahead and just ransom you. But with that one single battle, we're getting paid 178 ducats. Our allies are sharing 20 prestige. We have increased our opinion on our allies. And Duchess Mano's glory vassals lose opinion of her. I gain 20 prestige and my allies share 20 prestige. So, greetings, King Stockard of Sweden. Blessings upon you and your house. I know when I'm defeated, it seems I'm left with no choice but to comply with your demands. Not bad at all. Yeah, it is definitely safe. I'll look away for 2 seconds. In Skjallland, it's apparent that was a weird graphical thing. you're burning down because of Count Tolt's claim on the whole kingdom. You somehow lost Gjallarhorn, and I may not be getting a claim on you after all. And that's kinda alright. This whole end of the series is meant to be a celebration of all that I have achieved. And what I could possibly achieve if I felt the want to continue the series. Personally, I would very much like to, but with how the game is, I would rather wait to do a much more longer series when the game is fully up to date. And I hear that there are even more DLCs coming along for CK3 very, very soon. And so while this may be a little bit of a lackluster ending with only one, performing two wars, let's remember where we came from. We start as Eric II, down here, not in Upland, but in Sturgis. We only had this county. We had to wrestle Sigtun from our cousin, Eric the Heathen, the last Asatruian ruler in Sweden. Then it was inherited by Edmund II, then Princess Ygritte, my great-great-grandmother. Then it was Eric II, then was passed down to Grimm the Wolf, and now me, Stockard the Handsome. We eventually completely united all of the Duchy of Uppsala and went from owning this, just the Kingdom of Sweden. We own the majority of Sampi. We own all of Finland. And our dynasty is on the thrones of Denmark. Not Norway, but that's alright. On the throne of Pomerania, which was the very first crusade that we went against and succeeded. On the throne of Barcelona, which we again succeeded handily, and they have... Well, you might be struggling at this current time. You have both achieved great things. Our dynasty is renowned. We are significant enough to be noticed by the whole world, and are close to being famous as well. We are a bloodline of noble veins, convergent blood, resilient blood, and we are architected geniuses. We are a house of warriors, and we are generational Belkos. The Swedish culture are strong believers, runestone raisers. We still have the old tang meats to settle debates. We are coastal warriors, and we are embracing the force and taigas that we call home. The culture itself is spreading to most of Scandinavian at large. We hold territories in the Duchy of Sumgatia and Prussia. We hold a bit of Estonia. But our crowning achievement is owning all of this. We are a strong economic source, with Uppland being the development capital. Sure, not on par of Constantinople or Rome, but we are keeping up with the wider European nations. We're not some backwater nation, but we are strong, with strong blood in our veins, and a hardiness that will see us through for centuries to come. We may rise, we may fall, It's Finland. Sweveland. Sweden is our home forevermore. And though I may be remembered as the handsome, I am a skilled diplomat, a good leader. I know my way around the taxations, but intrigue is not my favorite, but I am a learned man. I am humble to a fault, but I will stand for those when they have nothing to lose. And I will always be there to share a story with a good friend. I have a wonderful daughter, a wonderful son, and a wonderful heir to take my stand. I may not be remembered as one of the greatest kings of Sweden, but I will be remembered. I am King Stockard Stenkil, the Handsome of Sweden. 1155 AD, 89 years at the start of our campaign, I'm calling this to a close. But before I do my outro in earnest, what is Sweden up to and is like in the current day? Well, at the beginning of the 21st century, Sweden had just emerged from an economic crisis in the 1990s, by the end of it. And they were having a thriving economy after that crisis that they have been through. But, as we all know, the global financial crisis happened between 2008 and 2009, and Sweden suffered dramatically, having an arguably most difficult year for the country since World War II. During this period, unemployment climbed to about 8%. But all was not bad. Sweden did eventually recover, and recovered very, very quickly compared to other nations during the crisis. And for the most part, Sweden just kept on rolling. They had their troubles, they had their riots. For example, in May of 2013, Sweden was rocked by several nights of rioting that began in Stockholm, suburb of Husby, on May 19th, and spread to other Swedish cities by the end of the week. The initial catalyst of the rioting and arson was mostly by emigrated youths. And this forced Sweden to change its immigration policy to an extent. But again, Sweden kept on going. They kept their stance of both neutrality and trying to develop the nation to be more, to be better, always. And that is what Sweden, for the longest time in their history, has always kind of done. They've had periods of struggles, and then periods of rebuilding and betterment, and then periods of struggle again. And as of recently, within the last few years, Sweden took a stance by breaking their almost 200 years of neutrality, possibly longer, by joining NATO due to Russia's war in Ukraine. A long stance of neutrality. And they felt the need that we must make a stand. And they joined and they applied for NATO membership. And as of this recording, that is still in the process of being finalized. They applied to NATO membership alongside Finland, who has been accepted into the alliance. And currently Turkey and Hungary are the ones holding Sweden's approval into NATO proper, but I am confident that it will happen in due time. Sweden, as a nation, has always been one of being better than what we were before. You can look at it from the Vikings, from the Viking Age, all the way to today. Sweden, though many would look at them as a backwater nation in Northern Europe, it's actually a place to be proud of to those that live there. A rich, deep culture that I only touched on here and there throughout this campaign. And I highly do encourage you all to do further research than what I provide. But the history of Sweden, much like the history of our world in general, is complicated, rich, and a story that should be experienced with one's own eyes. And if you're a fan of music, I hear they got some pretty good metal bands. And make some complicated furniture. And they have some pretty good game developers out there. But with all that said, I've been Type 1 Dragon. You all have been awesome, and thank you for joining with me on this journey. It may have a not so climactic ending, but not all endings need to be flashy or boisterous. Some things can come to a nice, steady calm, like the waves after a large storm, coming to a nice stillness, and then you see the sun reflecting off its waters, its gold amber hue, painting a picture that just takes your breath away. I've been Type 1 Dragon. Until next time, stay safe out there, everyone. Oh, Hadoah.